I'm losing it.
I was squealing right now.
Okay, so at what point in your life did you realize you didn't want the conventional life of a husband and 2.5 kids?
For me, it was when I was 14 and I realized that people didn't do the nasty just to have kids. It was also for fun. And I realized I never wanted a man to touch me for any reason, ever. And therefore, I could never have children.
If you like me, you'll keep your hands over your head for 10 seconds.
Okay. Stop.
What do you mean?
I mean, you're being weird. What?
Oh my God, what's on your shoulder?
There's nothing on my shoulder. Oh my God.
So on Friday evening, I went on a date with a woman for the first time ever. And I was really, really nervous, and we met at a park and we set up a picnic and we both made a bunch of food for each other. We both made way too much food. And once we met each other, the first 5 minutes of the date were just spent being like, "You're so beautiful. No, you're so beautiful. No, you're so beautiful." And then we were just talking so much that it took us an hour before we actually started eating because we had so much to talk about. And then I thought I got my period, which I did, on the white sheet that she had put down under me. And instead of freaking out or saying that's gross, she was like, "That is so beautiful and holy." We ended up talking at the park for 6 hours until everyone else was gone. And then we went to her house and she made a fire to keep us warm and she brought out mugs of tea and snacks for us. And we were just talking and laughing so much that we didn't realize it had been 9 hours. Is this what dating women is like? So on Friday evening, I went on a date with a woman for the first time ever. And I was really, really nervous. And we met at a park and we set up a picnic and we both made a bunch of food for each other. We both made way too much food. And once we met each other, the first 5 minutes of the date were just spent being like, "You're so beautiful. No, you're so beautiful. No, you're so beautiful." And then we were just talking so much that it took us an hour before we actually started eating because we had so much to talk about. And then I thought I got my period, which I did, on the white sheet that she had put down under me. And instead of freaking out or saying that's gross, she was like, "That is so beautiful and holy." We ended up talking at the park for 6 hours until everyone else was gone. And then we went to her house and she made a fire to keep us warm and she brought out mugs of tea and snacks for us. And we were just talking and laughing so much that we didn't realize it had been 9 hours. Is this what dating women is like?
Where's the flavor? Where's the flavor in this? I don't taste anything.
Wow. This is incredible. The flavor is immaculate.
What?
I didn't say anything.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Because you're beautiful.
Oh my God.
I enjoy looking at beautiful people.
I am bisexual. Here is a very common thing that happens when I say that to a straight man. His eyes just go wide. Smells something juicy. He goes like, "You're bi?"
"Yeah."
"So you, that means, have you kissed a woman?" "Yes." Have you? "Oh, I've kissed tons of women. Women all the time, every day. But you kissed, so what? What's that like?" "Well, you just told me that you kiss a lot of women, so I feel like you know, and I don't need to explain." "Well, I'm just curious, you know. What's it like, you know, like woman to woman?" He has some fantasy in his head about women making out, and I'm not his personal saucy thought for the day, okay? He's sexualizing my sexuality. Ew.
So I got this hoodie today and I think it is so cool. It's like, I love it. And when I say I got it, I mean my girlfriend got it for herself, but we're lesbians, so it's mine now. Ready, baby, let's go.
You forgot something.
What?
You forgot something. Before you go to sleep. Good night, love you.
So I remember I was 7 years old. Being gay was not something that was openly talked about, so I thought there was something genuinely wrong with me. And that's why I hid it for 14 years. I regrettably forced myself to date numerous men just to prove to myself that this is what I was supposed to be doing. Until I laid eyes on my very first girlfriend, I realized, shit, I really am a lesbian. Not gonna lie, I still do have regrets that I pushed myself so far into the closet and waited this long, but I have never felt this much love and support from anybody in my life, and the amount that I get from the LGBTQ community is absolutely unreal. And this is exactly why I am doing everything that I can in my power to do what I can do for you and what I couldn't do for my 7-year-old self. I love our community so much, and happy Pride Month!
I kid you fucking not, I'm in the Tops parking lot looking for a reusable bag, and the person that like collects the carts, obviously gay, you know, short hair, male clothing, like not to make stereotypes, but like come on. And she looks at me and she goes, I like your hat. I said, thanks. And then I looked away and then she goes, I like your bun. Thanks. And then I looked away and he goes, I hope you have a really nice day. It's beautiful out. And I was like, yeah, thanks, you too. And I awkwardly ran into the store, not run, but like walked. And then I'm like in the store looking for my shit, you know? And then she walks by me and does one of these. What?
Ow! Sucks that you're always a bottom.
I know I'm the bottom.
I'm the top.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No.
What makes you say that?
No, but first of all, you won't say it sucks because I'm always a bottom.
Hmm? You're a bottom.
No.
Yeah? No?
No. And you know when I'm taking control, I'm the top. What?
Willing.
What? What?
Nothing.
No, sir.
I'm just razzing you. I want you to take control.
So, I know I look terrible, but I just finished She-Ra and I'm absolutely sobbing because for the first time in my life, a lesbian couple ended up happy on screen together as the main characters, not as the side characters, not as the token gay characters, and not dead or broken up or sad, but actually happy. And I've been sobbing for like 10 minutes now. And my parents don't get it because they've always seen themselves on screen. And they, you know, but gay kids, LGBT plus kids, you deserve to see yourselves happy on screen and not dead or the angsty kid. So the representation's important. It's really, really important. It's so important. And thank you, She-Ra, for giving me that. Thank you.
Basta!
Hey.
Don't say it, don't say it, don't say it, don't say it. You're Nikki.
Okay, so this is a vlog of my sister's wedding day. There's Mr. Pretzel on the floor there. We started off by doing some hair. Once hers was all done, she helped me with mine too. Had to go give Mr. Pretzel some pets, of course. And then Maina and I decided that we should take him outside for a little walk. That's her fiance. We came in and got dressed and got all ready to head over to the venue. Had a little jam session in the car, of course. They put us in a room with a foosball table, which was pretty fun. This was after the wedding. We were all getting some pictures. These are the other bridesmaids. Princess's, Tori's sister. We came in for a toast and to cut some cake. They had absolutely no idea what they were doing when it came to cutting the cake, so that was pretty funny. But the rest of the night, we just went to dinner and hung out and celebrated. So that was pretty fun. Thank you, Tori, for letting me be your maid of honor. It was a blessing to be a part of your special day. You two are absolutely perfect for each other. I hope you have a happy life.